beautiful one. Ooh, the whole town. Ooh, beautiful.
Yeah, he said.
The whole town here.
For college, formerly voting to make Joe Biden the 46th president, and of course the raging coronavirus pandemic. That situation is at a monumental turning point tonight with the administration of the first shots in a nationwide mass vaccination program. One that many experts.
In his job, but I guess he saw a fit.
Despite the platitudes that the two of them bestowed upon each other, that it would be better to leave now than to wait.
Less than, or a little bit more than a month from inauguration.
This pardon investigation on the front pages, you see other things that are negative towards him and his administration, and there seem to be leaks. So I think the president's frustration is
Biden protecting those investigations came out. The perception of the attorney general changed. How much do you
by the AG? On the other hand, the AG has to be independent. I mean, there's a reason most of our states separately elect the AG. The governor doesn't appoint them. So how do you strike the balance of the environment changes?
Trey Gallant, former senator by Congressman Trey, thank you. We're going to bring in our panel with the breaking news by New York, chief political correspondent of the Washington Examiner, Mark Price, national political correspondent of National Public Radio, and the work of the Vendetta's publisher, the Federalist, and Steve Dowles. In the pause at the beginning of the show here, I'm Mark, I'll start with you.
Are a lot of points with the president, but there's just no doubt that the attorney general has been a very sensitive position with the president. President Trump became incredibly angry and held a long grudge against Jeff Sessions, his first attorney general. When Sessions recused himself from the Russia investigation, the president would cite the former Justice Department had not found evidence, and everything sounded fine, but clearly there's some serious conflict behind this.
Okay, Ben Domenech joins us now, and I want to bring into the conversation and play the soundbite. This is just from the interview with Brian Kilmeade. I referenced it earlier. Peter Doocy has a preview tonight from Wilmington, Delaware.
Joe Biden has already declared victory, but if the Electoral College confirms his win, the incoming president plans to address the nation and take a...
He's singing too.